And that's right, you're locked in to another show. It's going down, so you know. 99 Pod, let's get ready to pod here on God, keeping it real, no fraud. It's going down today. And when I tell you we have a loaded show, I mean, I ate before this show. I'm loaded. I'm ready to go. I'm all stacked up for the long drive here. I mean, a ton of news in all areas, man. We talking the NFL. Week 14 is in the books. We are talking the college football playoff, okay? We're going to talk about that. We're talking about a lot of stuff, MLB. I mean, man, it's nothing more that I love to do here other than talk sports, man. Nothing better. All right, not a better feeling in the world to be here with my guys locked and loaded on this show, Zach and Zay. I'm going to start off with my guy, Zach. How you feeling, my guy?
Well, doing well. Happy to be here with you. Happy to have Zay back as well. And it's funny because about 2 weeks ago when we were on this show, I did my usual speech right around Thanksgiving time when I said, you know what? This is really the best time of year for the NFL. This is really when you want to be playing your best football right around this time, because obviously the first few weeks, the first few months of the season matter for record and seeding. But I've noticed a trend over the years where if you really want to do some damage in the month of January, you better start playing your best football right around this time of year. And this is obviously a very important time. The weather starts getting colder. The games start becoming more important. The playoff races are becoming very tight. But I noticed something a little different, and you hinted at it in the intro this past weekend. Even though I was locked into the NFL on Sunday from start to finish, just like I'm sure we all were, I found my focuses on some other things. And we're going to hit on that today. All of those things, starting with the college football playoff. We got the 12-team bracket. I have a lot of thoughts on that. And the first year of the 12-team playoff, we've never seen this before. So I have some thoughts on that. We're obviously going to get into Juan Soto, a real changing of the guard moment in New York baseball. All three of us on this show are New York sport fans. We know how the sports landscape in this town has been our entire lives. And I think this event and this signing signaled a real change in that. So I'm looking forward to getting into all of that along with the NFL. And I'll pass the mic over to our guy, Zay, who we're happy to have back on with us this week.
Hey, Lou.
Mic check. Zay, the muted. You muted.
Apologize about that, fellas. Microphone issues already. But listen, it's been a crazy, crazy time in the MLB offseason. I call it fatigue because that's what it felt like every single day, waiting for the biggest star available in baseball to sign somewhere. We're going to talk about that more down the line. But right now, the NFL is hot. A lot of teams playing, some most underwhelming. We're going to talk about that shortly as well. But please like and subscribe to the channel. We're working hard here. It's always a good vibe when I'm here with Leel and Zach talking sports and giving y'all the most polarizing content available. So like and subscribe to the channel so you can tune in and lock into all of the content we have coming your way.
Definitely. I want to pick up where Zay left off. Make sure those of y'all watching on TikTok, y'all follow me here on TikTok. Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, Real Leel TV. Make sure you follow us. It's not 1999 anymore on all platforms. We doing it big. Man, in the words of Herm Edwards, you play to win the game, but guess what? We ain't playing no games on this show. We might as well begin with the first topic, bless you, my guy, in the NFL right now, and that is Buffalo. Okay, now, Josh Allen put up a monster performance, arguably one of the greatest games of all time, but they lost. And the question that we have right now is, will the Bills, losing ground on the number one seed, come back to haunt them? And Zay, the mic is yours to begin.
Yeah, I think this actually isn't going to haunt them at all. I think the way that the AFC has been playing this season, the Bills are still within grasp of that number one seed and still have a lot of games to prove and take that number one seed from the Chiefs. It's interesting how the Bills have been playing these last couple of weeks. They've been reliant on a plethora of their running backs, you know, Johnson, Davis, Cook, of course, the running back one, Josh Allen himself. So it's a lot of different factors that literally, and it's in the name itself, the ground game has been a huge component of their play style. It's just unfortunate that you had a historical night from Josh Allen which kind of puts them in that run, that number one spot for or MVP. And the Rams and Stafford themselves were just in prime mode. They were just dicing them up left and right. That's what we've seen when the Rams were on the championship run. We just saw them dicing up defenses left and right, and it was just unfortunate that the Bills could not cover ground and win that game after a historic night that Josh Allen provided. But I'm not worried about the Bills whatsoever. I think what we've seen from them week in and week out, that their defense elevates their play when pressure is applied, and I think we're going to see that in this basically down the line of the rest of the season. My last point real quick before I pass the microphone is that Josh Allen, like, this guy is, I think he's better than Superman. It's like this guy can do no wrong, literally. He has no weaknesses, and it's just like, what else can this man do? What else do you need this man to do in order to get some damn respect in the NFL? You got the mainstream media, First Take, dicing him up, talking about he needs to do more. He should have been better. What's more better than 3 passing touchdowns and 3 rushing touchdowns? This man did everything for this team. And we're seeing it more often, not only on the Bills, but on other teams, that the quarterbacks are doing all they can to put their team in a winning position. But somehow, some way, you find ways to lose the game. It's kind of crazy. But just to go back to the number one seed, I think the Bills are still right there. I don't think this loss will haunt them when the final standings happen on this season.
Zach, you up, man?
So both you guys mentioned that this was a historic performance by Josh Allen. And of course, you guys are right. But I just wanted to provide some more context into that. Josh Allen was the first player in the history of the NFL to throw for 3 touchdowns and rush for 3 touchdowns in the same game. No one has ever done that before. And it was an unreal performance. Unfortunately, his team did not come out on top. And when I look at the Bills, the loss was kind of predictable, I think, if you look at the circumstances. This was a Bills team that was playing great football going in. They had won each of their 7 previous games. The bye week was included in there as well. So prior to Sunday, the last time the Bills lost was the first week of October. That was that game in Houston against the Texans when they had a pretty big lead early on in that game. And I don't want to say this was a trap game or a look-ahead game, but I just think this game was more important for the Rams. The Los Angeles was healthy for the first time in a while. You saw Puka Nacua and Cooper Kupp making plays all throughout the game. As you see that brilliant throw to Shakir, he had, I think, his best game of the season. Or that was Hollins, actually.
That was Hollins, yeah.
Yeah, Shakir had, I think, had his best game of the season. He was very impressive. But it's a tough loss because the Chiefs won. So now you're 2 games back of Kansas City for that number one seed. And you have to go on the road to Detroit next week and take on the Lions, which is not going to be an easy game. Now, luckily, the schedule is pretty easy after that. You have 2 games against the Patriots and a home game against the Jets. So, look, when it comes to the Buffalo Bills, I don't think they're going to get the number one seed, which is a little bit of a bummer because obviously you would want that game, the AFC championship game, possibly to be in Buffalo. You would want anyone who wants to go through the AFC to come and go through your building. But one stat that I found interesting, and I knew it, but it didn't really hit me until doing some prep and research for the show today, is Josh Allen has never won a road playoff game. He is 0-3 when playing in the playoffs on the road. And this might have to be the year he finally does that, because when you look at the AFC right now, I still think Buffalo's right there, in large part because of their quarterback. One other thing that concerned me a little bit about Buffalo coming out of this game was when it comes to their defense. I think overall as a unit, they've played better and much improved this season. They're getting healthier, which I think helps. But they just don't really have that one guy that could completely wreck a game, right? They don't have a Max Crosby. They don't have an Aiden Hutchinson or a Chris Jones, a guy of that caliber that could just make a big play when you need to the most. And I think they really could have used that on Sunday against the Rams. And that's ultimately why I thought they ended up losing the game. They just weren't able to make that one defensive play. Now, I'm curious to see if they're going to be able to do that on Sunday in Detroit. Again, that's a monster game. The Lions are playing for the number one seed. If Buffalo wants to keep up their hopes as the AFC's number one seed, this is a game they're going to have to win as well. But I just think this loss hurts them only from the sense of they're probably not going to get the number one seed. I know they have the tiebreaker on Kansas City, but they would need the Chiefs to lose 2 more games in their next 4 in order to get that number one. And I don't think that's going to happen. So the only thing this loss really signifies to me is that if Buffalo wants to get to the Super Bowl, they're going to have to go on the road to Arrowhead and win. And Josh Allen hasn't done that yet, so he's going to have to prove he'll be able to do that.
So quick question, Zach. Do you think, you know, not really diving too much in predictions, but do you think that that's a bad thing for them to have to go in Patrick Mahomes' house and beat Patrick Mahomes?
Well, you'd rather the game be at home, right? I mean, yeah. Buffalo's one of the best home field advantages there is. I know Kansas City was able to go in there and win last year, but they played this year in Buffalo and the Bills beat them. So I think you would prefer that game to be at home. I'm not saying Josh Allen can't do it, but it's just funny. I remember right around this time last year when Buffalo and Baltimore finished ahead of Kansas City in the standings, a big talking point was, hey, Patrick Mahomes has never played in a road playoff game, let alone won one. How is he going to be able to do that? And he ended up going to Buffalo and winning, ended up going to Baltimore and winning. And Josh Allen's going to have to do that same thing.
And that's why the question is worded that way, because I think, not I think, mathematically, the Bills do not control their destiny to the number one seed. The Chiefs do. And with all the luck and just fluky things that have been going on with the Chiefs, that should be out of the playoff hunt right now if things flip the other way. I mean, you're going to have to go and patch in Mahomes' house and defeat him. So this loss by the Rams could actually have way more ramifications than what we are talking about, because we are looking at the game like, oh, Josh Allen, you know, even in a loss, MVP, he probably locked it up or have a good chance to do so next week. It's not a big deal. The Rams is more indicative of how good they are and how dangerous they are. But long term, we could come back and be like, this was a game right here. This was a game that if they won and the Kansas City Chiefs lost, that they could have had the number one seed and had the playoffs go through Buffalo. So, I can see it from that perspective. But before I get to my answer on that perspective, I do want to talk about the game a little bit, because I think the Bills defense, you know, obviously when Josh Allen has that type of performance, three passing and rushing touchdowns, 6 touchdowns has never been done. Obviously, complete body of work. The defense, you have to look, the logical thing to look at is defensively, and they were having trouble getting off the field on third down, which has been a microcosm of their season. Look, they haven't been that bad this year. I've actually been impressed when you consider the subtractions from the team, but they're 25 in the league in third down and getting off the field on third down, right? And obviously the Rams was able to convert 11 of 15 third downs in the game. Now, you do have to add context to that, because if you watch the game with your own two eyes and you're not reading the stats, you will see that there was a lot of spectacular catches that were made on those third downs. It was good defense. Like, for example, Johnson had tight coverage on Puka on a 3rd and 10. And I believe he had a 13-yard pass that he caught, which was in tight coverage. And then the sideline on 2nd and 10, he had like a sideline catch that he had like a tiptoe catch. I mean, you can't really have that type of footwork taught to you, okay, to this point. And Puka caught that, and then the touchdown that Cooper Kupp had, in which he had 2 defenders around him. So look, to me, yeah, you look at the Rams, they played spectacular. My guy Matthew Stafford looked like he was in his prime still, and Sean McVay with all those motions that give linebackers trouble, that could be a hell of a headache for your defense dealing with all the motions. And when you look back a couple weeks ago when they played the Chiefs and they got the 2 turnovers, the Chiefs didn't know how to handle the zone. They clearly have issues, even though they're winning games. So that's indicative of the Chiefs. But you look at the Rams, they was able to, you know, defeat the zone coverages, you know, with their offense against Buffalo. And I think when you come back to the clock management, which I think if you ask me anything about Buffalo, because a lot of people's talking about the defense, I just did. But if there's a major concern that tops that, it will come back to Mr. Sean McDermott in his game management, because on that final drive, I believe they wasted a timeout that if they didn't use, that they could have got the ball back. And now you're forced to kick a onside kick, which the probability is 2nd to 0. Okay. Literally, it's like, you know, why kick it? You lost. So that was bad. That cost them an opportunity to get off the field and get the ball back for Josh Allen to cap off his spectacular MVP caliber statement. Now, to answer the question, I'm in agreement with Zay. Zach, I don't really know where you stand fully, but I do think that even though they're losing ground on the number one seed, that they will not regret it, because I do think that this team can go in Kansas City and beat Kansas City. Number one, they have experience against Kansas City. they've been in this matchup before. Number two, they should have won a couple years ago. 13 seconds lives rent-free in my brain, okay? Now, one more point that I want to bring up, because, Zach, you brought up a stat that I want to expand on about Josh Allen haven't had won a road game yet in the playoffs. Think about the quarterbacks that they lost to in the playoffs, the Buffalo Bills in the Josh Allen McDermott era. Patrick Mahomes three times, Joe Burrow, prime Deshaun Watson. Okay, now think about the quarterbacks they beat in the playoffs. Mac Jones, Lamar Jackson, who we all know is a good quarterback but struggles in January, Skylar Thompson, and Mason Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. Okay, and a washed-up Phillip Rivers at that. So they're going to have to go and Patrick Mahomes and beat an elite quarterback for once in the playoffs, and we'll see if they're going to be able to do that.
A couple of things I'll respond, and then I want to throw something to Zay. So one point while you were talking, Lil, I didn't even think about was, not only is Kansas City, or whoever gets that number one seed, not only is that team going to get home field advantage, but that team also gets a first round bye. And one thing I've noticed too, and I'm not saying Buffalo is going to lose, but look, if you're the Bills or anyone, whoever gets that two seed, and you play the Chargers in the first round, we saw on Sunday night, that team is no joke, and they're going to give you a legitimate game. I think the same thing could be said with Denver if they get the number seven seed and have to play the number two seed. That game is no give me as well. I think the wild card in the AFC, those few teams are better than they've been in years past, so that's no guarantee. And also, Will, to your point on McDermott, I know that Zay has been the biggest Sean McDermott fan on this show, and up to this point in the season, he's been right, saying, look, this guy is one of the most disrespected coaches in the league. He doesn't get enough credit for the amount of winning he's done, and he's really been there throughout the whole Josh Allen era in Buffalo. And look, I don't think that late game execution on Sunday was by any means part of his greatest moments. I don't want to say he cost him the game, but he made a mistake that could have gotten Buffalo back into the game if he either would have thrown the ball there or just rushed to the line and spiked it. That's probably what I would have done. But Zay, I'll ask you, as someone who is a big McDermott believer, as someone who was the only person on this show before the season that had Sean McDermott ranked in their top five, what is your confidence level in him being able to get over the hump as the coach? Because I think Josh Allen being the star quarterback, he's really the guy that gets a lot of the focus and a lot of the conversation about this team and some of their shortcomings in the playoffs. But what did you make of that moment? And did that change your confidence level at all in him being able to get over the hump in January?
Well, I think McDermott was literally stifled. He's not going to admit it at all, but he was stifled at how well performing the Rams were playing against them, right? The defense has been destroying the AFC mainly the entire season. You play against the Rams, who now are fully healthy with Puka Nacua, Cooper Kupp, Kyren Williams, Stafford playing at an all-time level, and now these guys are firing on all cylinders. He was trying to find anything just to create a stop, because that's exactly essentially what was happening there. The Rams couldn't be stopped. And I think McDermott, you know, he made a crucial error there, and I don't think that's indicative on what's going to happen for the remainder of the season. I think that's actually a learning moment for him to try to get that extra gear to get their defense to play at, so that he can create that additional stop. So I think for me, it hasn't deterred me in believing he's not still in the running for coach of the year, or that he's not that his coaching needs to be in question. I think it was just a really crucial error, unfortunately, that cost his team to win and potentially the number one seed in the AFC.
I mean, look, I don't think you could coach, you know, backsides being tight, right? Because, for example, I know for me, as a test taker, right, obviously I think those days are a little bit over, because, you know, I graduated college, you know, I don't think I would have to take another exam for the rest of my life, hopefully, right? But I know for me, even if I studied, okay, my behind off, that naturally when I'm taking the exam and the clock is ticking, I am nervous, okay? And sometimes when you're nervous, you make mistakes. And I think based off the evidence that we have with Sean McDermott in those high, crucial game management moments, time and time again, he messes up. Even the Texans game earlier rings bells, right? Even, you know, the game against Denver last year rings bells. You know, the 13 seconds rings bells, right? So I think it's a reoccurring theme. It happened on Sunday that we really have to, you know, hold him to that standard of, okay, you may be the guy that's going to cost your team with those game management decisions that we know if you go to Kansas City, you're not blowing them out. It's not going to be a blowout. if you have to play Kansas City based off what we've seen with the evidence with them, it's going to come down to a double doink. It's going to come down to the referee. It's going to come down to the little nuances, some in your control and some out. So it's going to be close. You're going to have to step your game up. I mean, the things that worries me about the Bills team is their third down defense, because guess what? When you go to Kansas City, look at Kansas City. They're the best team in the National Football League on third down. So you have that dynamic that you have to worry about. And then also, I think it's coaching as well. And look, Sean McDermott is a good coach. He should be in the coach of the year conversations. I give Zay his credit. But the reality is, to me, they heard the MVP rumors and was like, listen, Josh Allen, go win your MVP. Because they got away from the running game. James Cook barely touched the ball. If they gave James Cook the ball early on, the game script could have been altered, and now they're not in a track meet in which their defense cannot hold up their end. So instead of them, Josh Allen, go win your MVP. Lamar Jackson got one. Joe Burrow made a Super Bowl. Patrick Mahomes got two. Make it do what it do. No, you make it do what it do to win the game and run the ball and make sure that you stop a hot, sizzling Rams offense. They didn't do that. So they may be going for the MVP, and by them going for the MVP, they may lose sight of what's really more important, which is the Lombardi Trophy that the Buffalo Bills fans deserve more than anybody.
You know, real quick before you get in, Zach, I want to say, you know, I think that 13 seconds is still tough. You know, I don't think that was a Sean McDermott issue. That was just them executing amazing plays at crazy times. You can't blame that 13 seconds.
They gave Tyreek Hill too much space for a guy his speed. Playing too far back, they gave him too much space.
I understand that, but it's just like, it's also like, bro, they had just such a great executing play. They was executing plays in 13 seconds. Like, that's just like unheard of. Like, this is the reason why people don't talk about, oh, that was a miscue on defense or anything of that nature, because of how great that was. It was just guys executing plays at an all-time high. Like, that's unfortunate, but there was no amount of coaching you can do to fix that. Because the only opposite of what McDermott did was what? Send the kitchen to the sink? Like, you know, send a blitz, like, it's fire to make sure you do a zero blitz. Like, there's nothing you can do in that situation to kind of stop any of that from happening. Because it was like, it was unfortunate. That's all it was. It was unfortunate. But I think McDermott himself, I think, like I said, he has a super young secondary. Milano's first game back. There was a lot of factors into that game. And now, you know, unfortunately, like I said, they lost the game. But I just think they're only going to get better as the games go on, especially with Matt Milano back in full swing, getting healthier, getting more adjusted to that defense once again. And I think we're only going to see a better defensive performance moving forward after just seeing a red-hot Rams team. You can't even knock the Rams. They played amazing throughout the entirety of that game, something we haven't seen from the Rams this whole season.
So I just wanted to respond to what Lil said. I thought he made some good points in regards to McDermott and some of his ghosts of the past when it comes to, you know, losing some tough playoff games. And when you compare the Bills and the Chiefs, because look, I'll say this, credit to the Steelers. They've been playing great football. And if Russell Wilson keeps this up, they could be in the AFC Championship game against either one of these two teams when it's all said and done. But I still do believe that the Bills and the Chiefs are on a collision course to meet in the AFC Championship game once again. And when it comes to that matchup specifically, I do think that the one big advantage Buffalo has right now is their quarterback and the way he's been playing. He's been the best quarterback in football this season, maybe the best player in the NFL this season, right up there with Saquon Barkley. But when you're comparing the two teams from their rosters 1-53 and their coaching, that's where I do give Kansas City the advantage. I'm going to take Andy Reid in a big game over Sean McDermott any day of the week. I think I would take Kansas City's defense over Buffalo. And even though right now the quarterbacks are comparable, I do think that the Chiefs, I would give them the advantage just because they've done it before. And now the game is it's looking like it's going to be in Kansas City again. And I think if you would have put that game in Buffalo, that could have been another advantage that the Bills had and could possibly have taken advantage of. But now they couldn't. And I do think that, especially the way the two games went down, if you would have said before the game, Josh Allen, he threw three touchdowns, ran for three touchdowns, and the Bills lost the game. And then on Sunday night, the Chiefs clearly didn't play their best game against the Chargers, especially in the second half. They didn't even score a touchdown in the second half, and they still found a way to win. That's just a tough blow for a Buffalo team that, when it comes to their specific matchup with Kansas City, they're looking for every advantage they got. And now it's looking like they're going to have to go to Arrowhead again, a place where Josh Allen has played in the playoffs twice. He's 0-2. That's not ideal. That's something I think this is a game Buffalo is going to want to have back.
please like and subscribe for all the up-to-date content. You've been slinging shows left and right, slinging content left and right. Please don't miss anything. If you do, like, subscribe, leave a comment, or leave a question, something you may want to answer, something you may have. All ideas are great ideas. Nothing's a dumb question.